consciousness and emotional thoughts. So one of the things I want to talk to you about is that they're connected. I'm not sure if you've been reading about what things are and how things are meaning. So what I like to do is connect consciousness to emotional thinking to your organic body. Now, I'll make those connections real quick. Now, let's go back to consciousness. Consciousness is part of the cosmology of the universe, okay? What do I mean? It's that it's connected to all things in the universe and how the biochemistry of the universe and how the electrons have always combined together or exploded each other or revolve around each other. That's the cosmology of the universe. Now, that's how the universe is made up. Now, consciousness is part of that because the consciousness is part of that gravity force. And gravity, we know, is not static. Static means is that it's always moving. It's always expanding. It's always contracting. So if it's always expanding and contracting, and we know the old science theory is that gravity sucks. That's because there's a pull to it. Now, on the other side of that, you know, going down to that equal level is that means there's an energy and momentum. That's the physics part about it. So you know there's things that's always moving and changing. Now let's go back to the consciousness. Consciousness meaning of thought, thought of the universe, thought is that everything's all connected through electron molecules and neutrons and the energy force coming back over here into the movement. That means everything you are thinking of moves. If you have what you call a fact, that means it becomes static. That means it just stays stationary until what? Until you get more information. So there's no fact that stands still like in gravity because there's a pull and there's a contract. There's things that evolves around each other or moves around each other. That's momentum and energy. When you are thinking and you have a thought, there's an emotion that's to it. In your body is the microcosm of the expanded universe. In your body, there is chemical revolutions of your, what you call your chemical, biochemical inside your body. So there's always expanding and contraction. There's an energy and movement. Don't think that just because you are thinking something and feeling something that there's no motion to it. Emotion, emotion, meaning equal, right? There's an E squared to the action of movement, emotion. Then if you add to feelings, then what about Dr. Paul? What about love and sadness, depression? Those are ideas of emotion. Those are what you call tags to emotion and how we are related to in our brain. More of our mind than anything. Because what we are conditioned to, pain, sadness, depression, happiness, and joy, those words that we've used, we try to explain it to what you call our thought process, but not our consciousness. Our consciousness has more to do with the movement of the matter of how it affects us, if that makes sense. So when we talk about energy and movement, and everything has a movement to it, right? Everything has energy. It's not static. It's not staying still. Once you settle in on just one fact and you are then become static, then you have no emotion to it, right? Emotion, movement. Think of it. See, if I'm emotional, things are moving. Now, not knowing where it moves to, and that's why I teach emotional reaction training, understand how that motion is carrying you. Understand how that motion is affecting you because there is a causal and effect to it, right? There is an action and a movement to it. Understanding those two different things will help you. So if you have any questions, you can always contact me at drpaulholisticscience.com. I hope we're going to do more of this, and I haven't done this in a little while, but a question came up to me and says, Dr. Paul, you haven't talked about consciousness and the movement inside the body. And most people just understand that how am I reacting to something is really causing me to do something that I don't want to do. Well, I want to tell you that that's an emotion connection to it. We need to understand how emotions are reacting.